Sweden has got some really awesome things about it. Not only is it great for its traditions and culture, but within its military, they have their own gear that is unique to the country. And in this video, we are going to look at Sweden's very own unique Stridvagn 122 main battle tank, which is one of the most impressive and heavily armored battle tanks in the entire world. How's it going, everybody? What's going on? Dave Welpel here, and welcome to FTD Facts, the channel where I look at people, cultures, and places from all around the world. And guess what? Yes, even militaries and military gear. And that's what we're going to do today. Now, before we get in this video, probably one of the most important things, if you love learning about military and all that sort of stuff, you'll want to subscribe because that's what we do. Well, that's what I've been doing quite a lot of. But the most important thing, if you guys are from Sweden, well, just to let you know, this is a continuation of our Sweden military playlist, which I'm going to put it in the cards throughout this video down there in the description box below. You can check it out at any time. But today, we are going to look at the Stridvagn 122, which is literally one of the greatest battle tanks in the entire world. And I'm going to ask the question, is it better than the Abrams? Well, we all know the Abrams is a really fascinating tank, so let's learn as much as we can about the Stridvagn, and you guys can answer the question down there in the comments section below. Now, the Stridvagn 122, sure, it's unique to Sweden, but it's basically based on the Leopard 2 or the Leopard 2A5, which you could theoretically say the Leopard 2A5 is kind of like Europe's main battle tank. Like, everybody in Europe loves the Leopard 2. And that would obviously be for the countries that do use main battle tanks. There are a lot in Europe that just say, nah, we want wheeled, not tracked vehicles. Now, prior to having the 122, Sweden had what was known as the Stridvagn 103, also known as the S-Tank, and even before that, they had the Centurion. The Centurion was made in service for Sweden from 1960 to somewhere in the 1990s, whereas the S-Tank was a turretless tank operated from 1967 to 1997. And this is about the time the Stridvagn 122 came into play for Sweden. So why did they choose the Leopard 2? Well, let's be real. During this time, Sweden was experimenting with many different tanks. Yes, they looked into the M1 Abrams, and yes, they even looked into the French Leclerc main battle tank. But for Sweden, they just found that the Leopard 2 and its design was perfect for what Sweden needed, and therefore they decided to put their own spin on this. And one of the main reasons why Sweden chose the Leopard 2 is not only was its design pretty much perfect, but let's be real, the cost of this tank was far less than the M1 Abrams, and it fits Sweden's budget perfectly. So back in 1994, even though the S-Tank and the Centurion had many upgrades at the time, Sweden was investigating these newer tanks to get in the game. The Leopard 2 had obviously been around since it was introduced in 1979, being produced by the Kaus Maffei company. But before the 122 had even come around, Sweden had actually ordered 160 of Germany's old Leopard 2A4s, in which these vehicles were named the Stridsvagn 121, in which this was the largest order Sweden's FMV had ever purchased equipment from a foreign supplier. And as well, when it comes to these 160 tanks, 29 of them were constructed in Germany, where the rest were constructed in Sweden under a new shared license. Interesting enough, though, Sweden didn't just purchase the Leopard 2A4s, they also invested in the Leopard 2A5s, which were newer and more improved. The Leopard 2A5 had major improvements such as an angled turret and many other major modifications, and when Sweden invested in this, they added their own modifications, thus creating the Stridsvagn 122, which began service in 1997. And by the year 2002, the Swedish Army had completed their batch of 122s, which came in at 120 of them. Which, by the way, these didn't come cheap. As a matter of fact, when it comes to the cost of these 122s and 121s, it came to approximately $770 million at the time. So you might be thinking to yourself, where are these numbers currently today? By the year 2000, Sweden had a major reorganization of its army, and with that, the 122s proved to be more beneficial than the 121s, in which during that time, the rest of the 121s were put into storage, and by the year 2011, most of them were given back to Germany, with Sweden keeping only approximately 12 of them as of 2014. I have no idea if they still have a couple of these 121s still lying around. I mean, some of you military boys that might be watching this video can fill me in down there in the comment section below. That would be greatly appreciated. But then again, guys, I'm talking about the 122, not really the 121. I do mention the 121 because it is the prior version and it is also important as well. Speaking about the Stridsvon 122, you might be wondering yourself, what does Stridsvon actually mean? Basically, off of a loose translation, this means Combat Vehicle 122. I know it's not really a creative title, however, a lot of people refer to these Stridsvon 122s as the Leopard 2S, I guess the S being Swedish. And with that, of these 120 Stridsvon 122s or Leopard 2Ss, the country currently only has about 42 of these tanks in active duty that are spread between three companies. Two of these companies are in Skarsborg and the third one is in Norrbotten. As a matter of fact, there's also a second variant of the 122 and that is the 122B. This version has upgraded armor that was found needed after the conflicts learned from improvised explosive devices that were used by enemy forces in Afghanistan and Iraq. To give you an idea, they installed composite armor that is aimed to deal with RPGs and is good for 360 degrees. So here's also a major question, besides the M1 Abrams, why is this particular vehicle better than something, say, as the 2A6 that the Dutch use, or even the 2A5? When it comes to the Leopard 2S, it is considered the most armored version of a Leopard 2 tank in the entire world. Not only does Sweden's Leopard 2S have an improved fire control system and Mexus turret armor in the front that was from the 2A5s, but also has a frontal hull and roof armor that was adopted from the 2A6s. As well, the Stridsvon 122 uses the French Galax smoke dispensers. And for those who are wondering where they are on the tank, they're those little tiny tubes that are on the side of the turret that were also found in the French Leclerc tank. Within this vehicle, the crew space has also been upgraded with fiberglass to protect them from shrapnel. As well, they have an improved chemical, biological, radiological, and nuclear defense system that protects the crew from those kind of attacks. But now, let's look at some of the specifics. So the weight of a 122 is approximately 62.5 tons. The B, however, is a little bit heavier by 770 pounds. The length of this tank from back to barrel is approximately 9.97 meters with a width of 3.75 meters and a height of 3 meters equally, which gives this tank a low profile. However, it is not quite as low as other main battle tanks such as the Abrams, the Challenger, or even the T-90. Within it, there is a crew of four like most battle tanks today, and as well, it has a 120mm Rheinmetall smoothbore gun barrel with approximately 42 rounds in one tank. As well, it has two 7.62 machine guns with approximately 4,750 rounds. The engine within this vehicle can go up to 1,500 horsepower with a power weight ratio of 24 horsepowers per ton. Like many other tanks in its class, it uses the Torsen bar suspension. It has a fuel capacity of 1,200 liters. Which I'm like, wow, I wish my car had that much, but then again, my car would be giant. And because of that, it gives it an operational range of 550 kilometers, going at a max speed of 68 or 72 kilometers per hour. So here is where we get into some of the interesting aspects of whether or not it's better than the M1 Abrams or whether it's not. Basically, in an intensive test from 1994, the Leopard 2A5 prototype won competition against the M1A2 Abrams and even the French Leclerc. And this was, of course, one of the major reasons why Sweden invested in this particular tank. But one of the major issues that Sweden was really looking at when it came to buying this particular tank was cost. For one of these individual units, it cost approximately $5.74 million US dollars, compared to the M1 Abrams, which is about 6.71 million US. So either way, guys, that is me looking at the facts of the Stridsvon 122. The question of whether or not one is better than the other, I mean, realistically, it's all about what Sweden needed and what they were looking for, and it fit their requirements. But if you guys want to let me know how you feel about it, you guys can let me know down there in the comments section below. But other than that, guys, my name is Dave Walpa, and for all you people out there, if you guys want to learn more about Sweden or Sweden military facts, be sure to check out the playlist at the end of this video, down in the description box, or up in the boxes that are in this video. But thanks for watching, I'm Dave Walpa, and I will see you guys later, and don't forget to hit that that subscribe button if it's your first time here. Okay? Bye-bye. So, all right, here's those playlists that I was telling you about. You could check out this one here about Sweden itself. Really great facts about the country. You'd be surprised at what you don't know. On the flip side of the coin, though, you can check out the military playlist where I've talked about many, many, many different departments, such as the Navy, the Air Force, and all that sort of stuff. So check them out, and you guys have yourself a good one. Bye.